In this video tutorial, I'll demonstrate just how easy it is to create a professional quality Redbook formatted CDR in just 3 easy steps using Sonic Studio's SoundBlade LE application. The first step is to drag and mark my audio files. I'll locate my audio files in the Mac Finder. I'll select them, and then I'll drag them over onto the SoundBlade LE project's top panel. But before I let go of the files, I'll hold down the Command key. SoundBlade LE will automatically create CD tracks displayed in the track bar from your audio files. Here we go, we'll look at all of them. We'll notice that each track has the name of its sound file associated with it. The order that you want these files to appear on the CD can be set by adding a leading 01, 02, 03 prefix to the song title, as I've done here. Remember that the command key is only needed just before you drop the files. The next step is to check my marks. From the Windows menu in SoundBlade LE, we'll select the Mark Info window. Next, select the PQ Info tab, and we'll notice that SoundBlade LE has placed all of the songs that were dragged into the project file into this window and automatically added the critical metadata needed to burn a CD, such as start marks or stop marks. Next, select the PQ Delivery tab in the Mark Info window. The status field here prompts us to insert media for delivery. I'll select the Eject button, which opens up the tray on my Mac. I'll insert a CD, and SoundBlade LE shows me in the status area that this is becoming ready for delivery. When ready to burn, SoundBlade LE's Mark Info status area tells us that media is ready for delivery. Next, click the Execute button in the Mark Info window to start the burn process. SoundBlade LE will ask you to specify a folder for the DDP image, and the CD will be replicated from the DDP image. Using the Finder browser, I'll specify a new folder for this DDP image. And then click the OK button. SoundBlade LE begins delivering your project to the blank CD. The first step is to generate the DDP image. The progress bar appears. So once the DDP image is generated, the CDR starts to burn. The status field here shows the burn progress. And when the burn process is completed, your great-sounding CD is ejected from the CD burner, ready to play. So here is a review of how to make a Redbook standard CD in 3 easy steps using Sonic Studio's SoundBlade LE digital audio workstation. Step number 1 is to drag and drop your audio files from the Finder into the top panel of SoundBlade LE's project window using the Command key. Remember that the Command key is only needed just before you drop the files. Step number 2 is to check your marks in SoundBlade LE's Mark Info window. And step number 3 is to burn your CD using the Execute button. A DDP image is created, and your CD is made. For more information about DDP images, see sections 3.10 and A1.5 of the SoundBlade LE User Manual, or visit this address. If any questions arise about how to use SoundBlade products, contact us at support@sonicstudio.com or visit our website.